I'm Amy Cherry. This local news is a service of Flagler County's Toyota dealer, Beaver Toyota, here to wow ya. A larger restaurant is coming within the confines of a Flagler County park, a move drawing ire from residents. John R. King has more.
All in favor, say aye.
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 All opposed, say no.
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 Motion passes 3-2.
And with that, the Flagler County Commission approved a $1 million expansion plan for Captain's Barbecue at Bing's Landing by a 3-2 vote. But the standing room only crowd was also divided, with many upset that what was once pitched as a bait and tackle shop with a small food operation has grown into a sit-down restaurant.
This is not a bait store. It is strictly a restaurant. And Mr. Coffey has been leading this here county around, not for our benefit, but for the benefit of the tenants.
Outgoing Commissioner Nate McLaughlin, in his last meeting as a board member, said his support was largely based on what was obvious about the business.
The success of that restaurant is evidence to me that Flagler County wants it there.
The plan will build a new eatery with as much as 1,000 square feet of additional space just north of the existing site, as well as additional parking. From the WNZF Newsroom, I'm John R. King.
This portion of Flagler's Morning News is brought to you by the Daytona Beach International Airport. Save time, money, and stress. The Daytona Beach International Airport, it's just plain easy.
I do solemnly swear or affirm.
Flagler County Commissioners Joe Mullins and Greg Hansen are sworn in a ceremony Tuesday. Mullins beat out two-term incumbent Nate McLaughlin in the August primary and then defeated Jane Gentile Ude in the general election.
Wow. This is actually happening. The mass voters of this community voted for a businessman with a different approach that will focus on growing this economy of our great county. I feel like my life has prepared me to serve this community, and I will do so with all my strength, my wisdom, and my faith.
Mullins says he'll work as the public's voice and strive to always do what's best for the community.
You know, in church, they said more families this year needing meals than we've ever seen before. That is a time that we need to bring high-paying jobs, stand strong with our Sheriff's Operations Center, and then change the reputation to a much more business-friendly community.
Hansen returns to District 2, but this is his first time being elected.
It's been my pleasure to serve this last 18 months or so as an appointed commissioner. It's really fun to be elected. It gives you a little bit more confidence in that people have faith in you, and they appreciate what you're doing. And I love this job. So, thank you.
Commissioner selected Donald O'Brien as chair and Commissioner David Sullivan as vice chair. Meantime, Palm Coast City Council swore in new members Jack Howell and Eddie Brancinho. Howell replaces Councilwoman Heidi Shipley and is the only Democrat to win an election in Flagler in the last two cycles. Brancinho has been a lifelong Democrat who switched to the Republican Party last June to win his campaign. He replaces Vincent Lyo. Be local, buy local. That's the motto behind Small Business Saturday. Tony Magoo has more.
The Palm Coast City Council is planning to proclaim November 24th, the Saturday after Thanksgiving, as Small Business Saturday in Palm Coast. I've got Palm Coast Mayor Melissa Holland. Mayor, talk to me about Be Local, Buy Local.
It's an effort and initiative to help our residents really fully understand the significance and importance of why you spend your dollars here.
And could you talk a little bit about cheating on Palm Coast, like going somewhere else?
Every time you shop outside this community, you're improving another's community. Every time you fuel up in St. Augustine, you're improving their roads.
Now, what's the upside?
The money stays here. You're helping support a local business who employs maybe your neighbor, and it instills that spending and that marketability to those that are looking to open up shop here.
If every resident of Palm Coast were to spend $25 at a local business on Small Business Saturday, it would bring in almost $1.5 million into our community.
Support your local businesses. The local economy will appreciate it, and certainly your local community will appreciate it. We'll be able to do more with those dollars every year.
For Flagler's Morning News, I'm Tony Magoo.
The Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade may be in New York, but three students from Matanzas High School will be there tomorrow.
Senior Cassie Clayton and juniors Serena Karvanka and Rose Riley will be part of the woodwind section of Macy's Great American Marching Band. The music is from the 2017 parade, but as the Daytona Beach News Journal reports, the three will be playing their clarinets as they perform in the 92nd annual event. It's not like they just went to the Big Apple to play. No, the News Journal reports that they had to audition for the band. Before that, they filled out online applications, posted videos to YouTube of playing and marching in their school's band, and all three of their applications were accepted. It's not the first time, though, that students from Flagler County have been in the parade. Last year, Flagler Palm Coast High School sent 5 who performed in the marching band and 1 who danced in the parade. From the WNZF Newsroom, I'm Deb Albertson.
And now you're up to date on Flagler's Morning News. I'm Amy Cherry.